So this is our video lecture on making solutions. This is going to be part of Unit 1 and will match up with Chapter 2 of our textbook. You should have a copy of the notes either electronically or printed out on paper. If you're doing it electronically, I recommend using Kami. And I also recommend using the stylus because you will be doing math writing, and I think sometimes that's hard to do in lines when you're typing text. So why do we need to talk about making solutions? Because they're very important in research and development, which is your R&D, QC, which is quality control, and MFG, which is manufacturing. So if you go into a biotechnology field, these are some of the different job positions you could have, especially as an entry-level biotechnologist. It's going to take a few years for you to work your way through the ranks, and so everyone sort of starts at the bottom. And one of the most important things you're going to do is making solutions. But it does not mean that you are without value to the team. Making solutions is very important. The accuracy is critical because if you're in the middle of a clinical trial and you're supposed to be responsible for making the different dilutions in order to test the drug and things like that, if you're working in a drug company or something like that, the accuracy of your solutions and your math being correct could be the thing that makes or breaks the final formula. And that's going to add time and is going to delay the product from getting to market, whatever it is. So even though, you know, you might feel like you're not the lead researcher, you're still doing a very important job. So some key terms here that we just want to review from chemistry. Remember, we're going to be talking about solutes and solvents. The solute is whatever substance is being dissolved in something else. That can be a solid or a liquid. It doesn't matter. And then the solvent is what is going to do the dissolving. So most often this is going to be a volume of water or even buffer, which is mostly water. These are the things that are going to make up your solution. So you're going to have solute and solvent mixed together to make your solution. The concentration of a solution is a lot of times what you're going to be doing the math for. You're going to be looking at the amount per volume. So a concentration would be like the solute per solvent. And when this makes a solution, it makes a homogeneous mixture where you have the solute dissolved within the solvent. So just to review what concentration means, here I have a test tube, okay? And let's say there's 5 milliliters of our total solution there, and each star represents 1 milligram of salt. So take a second, pause the video, and see if you can figure out what is the concentration of salt. 4 milligrams divided by 5 milliliters, okay? So anytime we say per, so solute per solvent, right? So 4 milligrams per 5 milliliters equals 0.8 milligrams per milliliter. So that is the concentration of this solution. So what kinds of calculations are we going to be doing? We're going to work on a few equations here. You do not have to memorize the equations. Those will be given to you on an assessment. Make sure you take your time with your calculations. For some people, math comes easy. For others, it's more difficult. Just keep things very, very organized and very structured. Remember, always write your formula and at the top, go through your calculations line by line, cancel your units, and ask yourself if the answer makes sense. So first, we're just going to talk about mass per volume, the simplest way of expressing a concentration. So 2 milligrams is the weight of your solute in 1 milliliter of solvent. So that's your total solution there. We could also express mass per volume as a percent. Okay, so if we want a 20% solution of our KCl there, and I apologize, that should be a lowercase l. But if we want a 20% solution of KCl, then what we would do is we would say, well, how do I get 20%? I would take 20 grams, right, 20 grams of mass of my solute and dissolve it in 100 milliliters of my solvent, okay? And so what happens if you take 20 divided by 100? It equals 20%. So you can use this as an equivalent fraction when you're doing your math. So let's do a practice problem. How would you prepare 500 milliliters of a 5% solution? Pause the video here, try and work it out on your own, and then go ahead. Here's the answer. We know that a 5% solution is the same thing as saying 5 grams per 100 milliliters. So you'll see here I've set it up. So I have 5 grams per 100 milliliters as a proportion equals X, what I'm looking for as how many grams I need, in 500 milliliters, okay? So I want to make sure I have the same 5% solution here, even though I've scaled up my total volume to 500. And then to solve that, you're just going to cross multiply, okay? And you'll see 100x equals 2500. And when we solve for x, we get 25 grams of salt. So there's the math portion. And then it's always important to leave room at the bottom to physically write out the directions for how you would measure this. So you weigh out your 25 grams, most likely using some sort of an electronic balance, and you're going to add it to the flask, and then you're going to start adding your solvent. In this case, it would be water. Now, you don't add 500 milliliters all at once, because what we're looking for is a total solution of 500. So you put your grams of NaCl into, let's say, your volumetric flask, that would be the best, and then you're going to start adding water to it and maybe add, half to 80% of where the total amount should be. And then you're going to mix that, okay? So we want the salt to go into solution. We want it to dissolve. That's going to give you your proper volume level moving forward. Then just continue adding your water until it fills up to a total volume solution of 500 milliliters. A lot of times in biotech, and most often this will be the formula we use, we're going to use the diluting percent solutions. So when you receive materials from science companies, they're going to send them to you as stock. Okay, if you think about it, when you look at your shampoo bottle, this might break your hearts a little bit, but when you look at your shampoo bottle, almost 90% of it is water. And what you're paying $7, $8, $9 for in the bottle is water. You're paying for the size, the amount of plastic that it takes to have all that. Whereas if you could just get your concentrated solution, your bottle would be much smaller, and then you could add your own water to it to create the concentration that's needed. That's also what we're going to do with a lot of our reagents. So for example, many of your buffers come highly concentrated, and then you're going to need to dilute it depending on the needs of your procedure. So in this formula, C1V1 equals C2V2, you're going to multiply concentration and volume of initial, and that's going to be equal to the concentration and the volume of the final, okay? Concentrations do not have units, so your only unit here will be with the volume, and most of the time that'll be in milliliters. You must have three of the four of these variables known in order to solve this equation. So make sure when you're doing this problem that you identify what you've been given. And you should be able to identify three of the four variables, and that will tell you how you're going to solve for the fourth. So here is a problem. You want to make 500 milliliters of a 1 molar, that's your concentration, right? A 1 molar Tris buffer. And it's coming from a 3 molar stock solution. Now, I see three numbers here. Two of them are concentrations, and one of them is a volume. So what you have to work out is which ones are going to be C1 and V1, and which ones are going to be C2 and V2. Okay, and remember, the 1 always means what you initially have now, and the 2 means what you want to end up with. All right, so pause here, see if you can fill it out. and then solve for your unknown. So when we look at this, we're given a 3 molar stock solution. So that's our initial concentration. And we don't know how much of that we need. So therefore, our initial volume of that stock solution is unknown. We do know that in the end, we want a total volume of 500 mils, and we want a concentration of 1 molar. So then it's really just plug and chug. So set it up, C1, V1 equals C2, V2. Then you're just going to use good algebra to solve for X. In this case, X is 166.67 milliliters. Don't forget your units. And always end by solving for, by explaining how you would do the measurement. So in this case, we're dissolving a volume inside a volume. So this is a liquid in a liquid. So you're going to measure out your milliliters of the stock solution of the Tris buffer. And then you are going to add it to the other half, the other portion, to make 500 milliliters total. So always add your concentrated buffer first. And since it's a volume, a liquid dissolving in a liquid, you don't have to worry about the fill up rule. Okay, it's already going to be dissolved, and you're just going to add it to the remainder to make 500 milliliters of your buffer. Give it a good mix, bottle it up, label the bottle, and you're good to go. All right, let's try one more. Pause the video here, see if you can work it out. Here is what we have. So we wanted to make 100 milliliters of a 0.15 molar KCl solution, and it's coming from a 10 molar stock solution. So again, our X here is V1, and our final volume V2 is 100, and our final solution here, our final concentration here is 0.15, okay? So when we solve for that, we get 1.5 milliliters. So what we would do is we would take our concentrated KCl solution. We have 1.5 milliliters of that measured out. Then we would add 98.5 milliliters of that for the total volume of 100 milliliters. Okay? So those are just some example practices to help guide you as you do your practice worksheets. If you have any questions, please let me know. Remember, the practice worksheets, you will always receive the answer key at the end when you are ready to check your work. This isn't about testing your knowledge. This is about practicing it. So if math isn't your thing and it makes you nervous, don't worry about it. We will work on this together.